Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to Morocco's King Mohammed VI on His Majesty's accession anniversary, wishing the brotherly Moroccan people further progress and prosperity under his wise leadership. His Majesty the King praised the constantly growing bilateral relations between the two countries and people. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa has ratified and issued laws 32, 33, 34, and 35 of 2018. His Majesty the King ratified and issued laws 32, 2018, endorsing the third protocol amended of Bahrain-U.S. Free Trade Agreement, the FTA, signed in Washington on November 30th of 2017. His Majesty the King ratified and issued law 33 of 2018, amending Article 30 of Law 3 of 2002, on regulation of municipal elections. His Majesty the King also ratified and issued the Public Health Law 34 of 2018, rescinding Law 3 of 1975, Law Decree 14 of 1977, and Law 3 of 1985 regarding important foodstuffs, endorsing currently applicable rules and resolutions wherever not in breach of this law until issuance of the relevant rules and resolutions stipulated in this law. His Majesty the King also ratified Law 35 of 2018, endorsing Bahrain's accession to the agreement of the establishment of the Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa visited today Bahrain Defense Forces General Command. Upon arrival, His Majesty the King was received by the Minister of Defense Affairs, Lieutenant General Yusuf bin Ahmed Al Jalahma, and the Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Ziyad bin Sagr Al Naimi, as well as a number of senior officers. His Majesty the King was accompanied by the Royal Guard Commander, His Highness Brigadier General Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and the Royal Guard Special Force Commander, His Highness Major Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty discussed the BDF's participation in the Restore Hope operation in Yemen as part of the Arab coalition forces led by Saudi Arabia, which provides humanitarian efforts to aid Yemeni people under the leadership of the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdul Aziz Al Saud. His Majesty the King hailed the courage of the Saudi-led coalition forces in combating terrorist attacks, expressing pride in the BDF members' contribution to defending the south of Saudi Arabia, which reflects the deep-rooted relations between the two countries. His Majesty the King wished them success in their duties. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to Morocco's King Mohammed VI on His Majesty's accession anniversary, wishing the brotherly Moroccan people further progress and prosperity under his wise leadership, and praising the strong fraternal ties between the two countries and people in various fields. His Royal Highness the Premier also sent a similar congratulatory cable to the Moroccan Prime Minister Saad Din Al Othmani on this national occasion. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to Morocco's King Mohammed VI on His Majesty's accession anniversary, wishing the brotherly Moroccan people further progress and prosperity under his wise leadership. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince praised the constantly growing and deep-rooted amicable ties between the two countries and people. Youth City 2013, in its third week, provides an array of professional programs capitalizing on the strength of Bahraini youth to help them excel in their scientific and practical lives and develop their artistic skills. More in this report by Hiba Abdul Ghaffar.
In its third week, Youth City 2030 is still committed to changing lives through professionally organized practical projects formulated according to scientific studies, focusing on key growth areas of Bahraini youth, aiming to promote creative thinking among them and encourage talent in areas such as leadership, media, information technology, arts, languages, science and sports, confirming the Ministry of Youth and Sports' commitment to prepare them to enter the labor market in accordance to the realistic requirements of Bahrain and the world.
This is my fifth year in Youth City. I've joined this year TVC, which is television commercials. We are in the progress of planning and writing the script of the commercial. We have several actors we're casting throughout this week. And inshallah, soon we'll be making a wonderful commercial. In the next 2 years, I want to study media in university. And inshallah, I will become a TV host.
This year, I joined the sports center in Youth City as my third year. This year, I'm a participant, hoping to be an organizer next year. And Sport for Social Change team is actually been very, very good. I like it so far, as we're learning to become how to become a better person, sport-wise and like socially. And I hope that this step goes further as we grow up in our lives.
The development of the potentials of participants, the new skills they're learning, and the additional knowledge they're gaining are nourishing their dreams and encouraging them to be better versions of themselves.
Basically, we take wooden things, anything that's garbage, and we just paint it, we fit it, we just turn it into anything that's good for our living room. We're currently making shelves and tables, coffee tables, anything that's like that. We turn them, we paint them, we do everything, and we just turn them into a furniture. And then after that, we're gonna put them outside, and then we're gonna sell them to the people. And basically, the program is just teaching us how to recycle things. And I think that's a great idea, because our world needs to be more recycling, because it's getting destroyed over and over again because of waste. So I think it's a great idea that we turn anything into a furniture for our houses.
To learn something new and to broaden my knowledge in the arts section. What I've learned from this experience is I've learned how to use unusual or peculiar products or things to make an art piece. For example, we have used nails and cotton to make an art piece, as you can see. And now we're working on more projects.
Whether through personality development or skills training, Bahrain is investing in its future.
Youth City 2030 is a life-changing experience, providing youth with skills and additional knowledge and nourishing their dreams to help them excel in their practical and scientific lives. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Hiba Abdul Ghaffour.
The Khalid bin Hamad League, which was designated for players of all sectors, kicked off the disabled team's matches this week, spreading awareness of the importance of sports among the youth and highlights the excellence of local sports talents. More in this report with Yasmin Ibrahim.
The Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad tournament is committed to providing opportunities and improving access for disabled people with a love for football. The league, which has continuously worked hard to build momentum off the back of this glorious success, continues to push for disabled people to have equal rights and access to football.
We are very proud of participating of disabled teams. We have 8 teams. This participation was from the 4th edition, because His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Khalifa taking care of them. They are a main figure in our league as a whole. You have 6 leagues, but they are a main figure in our league. I think 8 teams participate in this 6th edition, and even the people who came to support them from their families also. So we are very proud, we are very happy we have these people with us.
The tournament continues to support disability inclusion in football, which was made apparent with the increase in number of participating teams to a total of 8 teams this year, which was among the remarkable achievements of the Khalid bin Hamad tournament, which aims to empower disabled teams and engage them to take up the sport.
Actually, the participation of these teams give us we are, as mentioned to you, we are very proud of them. And also we have different teams. We said about youth centers, we said about the clubs, we said about the communities. These people also also making complete the circle, I mean, in the whole league, you know, because they are also one of the main league in the whole league.
Football has the third highest participation rate in disability sport, and the Khalid bin Hamad tournament continues to be the ideal platform for fostering the inclusion for anyone with a disability or additional needs, regardless of impairment. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Yasmin Ibrahim.
The King Hamad Global Center for Peaceful Coexistence Board of Trustees Chairman, Dr. Sheikh Khalid bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, affirmed the keenness of the center to promote the culture of coexistence that Bahrain has adopted for centuries to achieve stability in the world. In an event organized by King Hamad Global Center in cooperation with This is Bahrain Society in Madrid, Spain, last Thursday, Sheikh Khalid bin Khalifa stated that Bahrain, under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, has guaranteed the rights and freedoms of all religions and their protection under the law. He recalled the launch of the Chair in the Name of His Majesty the King at La Sapienza University in Rome to promote the values of moderation, international coexistence, and combating terrorism and extremism. The non-resident ambassador of Bahrain to Spain, Sheikh Fawaz bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, underscored the friendly relations between Bahrain and Spain, noting the Spanish community's hospitality and religious tolerance, as well as their peaceful coexistence. The event was attended by members of the diplomatic corps, followers of different faiths, civil society organizations, and faculty members of Spanish universities, as well as various media and Spanish channels.
The King Hamad Global Center for Peaceful Coexistence, in collaboration with This is Bahrain, organized an event in Madrid for the first time to present and explain the vision of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa of religious freedom and peaceful coexistence. Guests from all over Spain flew in for the event and were eager to learn of the Kingdom of Bahrain's pioneering role in this regard under the leadership of His Majesty the King.
We have chosen Spain because of the similarities that we have in both societies. In Spain, people for centuries have been living peacefully with peaceful coexistence and tolerance with many, many religions, many sects, many races. And here also in Bahrain, we have the similarities. So therefore, we thought that we can have the experiences of both of us, of both of the countries. Adding to that, you know, the relationship between the royal families and the leadership have established a very strong link. That link, in fact, we can see it in the minds of the people of Bahrain and Spain.
When you come to the Spanish people or to come to any other countries and come to the society itself and talk to the people and show them how much of a culture, of tolerance, of peace message that it will spread between them, I think this is a really great thing. And I'm honored to be here. I feel this is my place.
It comes at a time where the Arab world and the Islamic world needs it the most, and we are really proud and pleased to have this important activity is being hosted here in Madrid, Spain, and we are really behind it 100%, and we support it.
The event was attended by a wide range of members of diplomatic corps, followers of different faiths, civil society organizations, students of numerous Spanish universities, as well as a remarkable presence from various Spanish media.
I'm very impressed with what the king is doing, or the culture of the kingdom itself has done in the last years. And I think it's a very good example, an example that we should follow in many other countries, perhaps the rest of the world.
Oh, the message of His Majesty is absolutely great. It's magic, it's about love, it's about brotherhood. And here in Spain, we love to get embarrassed these two concepts.
The vision that His Majesty has put out for the world to follow is unequaled. We cannot say enough about his hard work as making us feel proud of what Bahrain has done to us and to the rest of the world.
The guests at the event also witnessed a presentation regarding the Declaration of the Kingdom of Bahrain. The King Hamad Chair for Interfaith Dialogue and Peaceful Coexistence at La Sapienza University in Rome, the King Hamad Global Center, and the efforts of the Kingdom of Bahrain to promote a culture of coexistence.
Today was a really good experience because we had the chance to know about the Bahrain culture. We had the opportunity to know more about the King Hamad, and that was really a good, a good chance to know more about all the culture that we are now able to, and I think we have learned a lot.
First of all, I've discovered more about Bahrain than what I was expected to know. So because, you know, sometimes we talk about the Gulf countries and about the monarchies from the Gulf, but we don't know more in detail, sometimes beyond Saudi Arabia or Kuwait. But here we've learned more about Bahrain.
I think this experience is very interesting because it's bringing two different cultures into the same place, and a lot of different people from different religions and backgrounds are here together today. So it's an example to follow, hopefully, in other nations and countries, and definitely very enriching in terms of culture and religious learning as well.
So I think the presentation was very informational in the way that it taught us about, like, us being from Spain and Europe, and Bahrain being a country that is not so familiar to us. It was very good for us to see how Bahrain is a different country to its neighboring countries.
The success of the event was a clear indication of the rapid spread of His Majesty the King's vision internationally, with all guests praising the diversity, freedom, and pluralism characterizing the Kingdom of Bahrain.
The vision of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa of religious freedom and peaceful coexistence continues to inspire the rest of the world to follow in the footsteps of the Kingdom of Bahrain. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Shoghi Mohammed.